250.
I got my copy.
This past week, Anthology selling over a 250,000 copies. What a great triple CD set. If you haven't got it yet, get out and get it. Folks, so much to talk about within the hour, but Lita Survivor Series more than surpassed what we came to expect from a normal Survivor Series.
From just a normal Survivor Series.
Think of the Elimination Chamber match. Nobody saw the Elimination Chamber till Sunday morning, but after what those six superstars went through, I don't think any of them will ever be the same.
Win, lose, or draw, six guys came out feeling it for sure.
Oh, big time, and come Monday on Raw, they were certainly still feeling it. And folks, right after this matchup, we're gonna take a look back at the Elimination Chamber match and what a great night it was last Sunday in New York City. But here we go, the Hurricane one-on-one with Justin Credible.
But did Eric Bischoff give those guys a break? Oh, no, he did not.
No, which goes back to Lita.
Yes.
Us always talking about Eric Bischoff not concerned about the well-being of a superstar.
A friendly handshake by the Hurricane.
Oh, but Justin Credible wants no part of it.
Because he's showing her that he's not just the coolest and not just the best.
No, Justin Credible! We've only been on the air for 2 minutes.
We already got it out of the way.
Yeah, it's true. It is out of the way. But, folks, we're going to talk all about Survivor Series. Of course, coming up, we're getting set for Armageddon, only a couple of weeks away. And huge news this week. Oh, nice head scissors by the Hurricane. We announced this week that coming in January, Raw's 10th anniversary, we're going to be telling everybody about that over the next few weeks as well. Wait a second. Here's a cover. Hook leg 1-2 and a kick out.
It seems like just yesterday.
Raw was kicking off.
It was just a little baby Raw.
Yeah, who would have ever thought that Raw would become the most successful cable series of all time?
Who would have thunk it?
Yeah, nobody could have. Well, now Justin Credible. Ooh, quick as a cat. Big time into the nether region. Now the Hurricane.
Look, Jack, it's the top of the arena. Chad.
That's Chad. Well, they're like twins anyway. Chad and Jack. They do everything together. Now the Hurricane.
We don't need to go there, Coach.
The crowd 100% behind the Hurricane at this point. I think referee Chad Pat taking a little offense to that. And now Justin Credible, a big shot now, trying to recover from that big shot to the groin area a few moments ago.
The aforementioned spoken of.
Yeah, exactly. Now the Hurricane into the corner and certainly feeling the effects, courtesy one Justin Credible. Folks, a little bit later on, D'Lo Brown goes one-on-one with Johnny the Bull Stamboli. And apparently we're going to have another installment of Raven's Master Plan. Raven wasn't too happy with us a couple of weeks ago because, and I'll give him credit, he does have a point. Here's a cover, hook and leg, 1-2, and a kick out by the Hurricane.
I think it's more his personal feelings towards Milan. He hates Milan.
Well, yeah, he didn't like Milan too much. I don't think Milan will be making another appearance here on Heat.
We fired
him. Just a hunch. Just a hunch. Well, now, Justin Credible in control. You can see the Hurricane. He may actually be out at this point.
Justin excited about the possibility of no more Hurricane for tonight.
I tell you what, to say that Justin Credible at this point needs a big win, and a big win over the likes of a Hurricane would certainly be an understatement in my opinion. Oh, now the Hurricane.
He is Justin Credible.
Well, that is, oh, nice sunset flip. Can he get Justin Credible down? No, a big shot to the head. Oh, there it is now, though. A wrong 1-2, quick. Oh, and nearly a 3 count on Justin Credible.
Right back down goes the Hurricane.
You know, these two guys have been going toe-to-toe for several minutes now. How much does either man have left at this point, which is one of the questions we were asking last Sunday at Survivor Series. I mean, this Elimination Chamber match was so dangerous. So dangerous, in fact, that Triple H had to go to the hospital after the match.
Triple H with a crushed trachea, not even able to make it to Raw last Monday night.
Yeah, you gotta wonder when Triple H will be back as Justin Credible completely telegraphs that move, and the Hurricane is able to catch Justin in the kisser.
Justin with the teeth.
Justin with the teeth. I think he ate a few teeth on that one. And now referee Chad Patton with the 10 count is Justin Credible back to his feet. The Hurricane attempting to do the same. And now, the Hurricane, big shots to the forehead. Oh! And a big forearm to the forehead of Justin Credible. And now the Hurricane with the, dare I say, yes, and D'Lo wasn't even out here. Oh, nice flying neck breaker by the Hurricane.
Shining Wizard.
The Shining Wizard, but it was not enough.
It's a wonderful kick, but it was not enough.
I just wanted you to reinforce it for the fans out there who may not be familiar with that move. It's all about an educational process here on Sunday Night Heat. Well, now the Hurricane wondering at this point, Lita, what he can do to take out Justin Credible.
Justin Credible raking the ice through the mat.
Oh, my goodness.
And a sunset bomb.
Sunset bomb. Oh, and the Hurricane, what an upset.
Justin
in
complete shock. Now, you don't need to go take this out on the referee. That was a two count, Justin, two count.
What an impact. You heard the Hurricane in the middle of the ring. And now a roll up, Justin Credible. One, two, oh, and nearly a three count again as Justin Credible almost screwed himself.
Almost.
Hurricane going for the choke slam. And I cannot remember the last time we saw that actually work for the Hurricane. Oh, wait a second.
We have not seen this in a long time.
Wow, you set it right, and oh, such a dangerous move.
The vertebra broken.
Do not try that at home. The Hurricane, though, very effective over Justin
Credible. The Hurricane!
Look of intensity in the Hurricane's eyes.
Big time intensity. We don't leave.
Hey, Stevens, I'm going to explain to you and everyone else out there who was too simple-minded last week to follow why I am compelled to create this masterpiece. It's because you and everyone else out there are filthy, immoral degenerates. Yet you refuse to admit it. You hide behind a mask of normalcy. You call people like me depraved, people who aren't afraid to be who they are in order to deflect attention from yourself. I will use the seven deadly sins as a backdrop to illustrate the hypocrisy of mankind. This will be my masterpiece. But before I begin, I'm going to give you a chance to achieve salvation first. Admit to me now that your life is a lie, that you are a different person than you claim to be, and take your first step towards salvation. Because have no doubt that if I must, I will hurt you. I am a righteous man on a mission, and I will hurt you if I have to.
I don't have anything to admit to, and I'll see you in the ring tonight, freak.
This is gonna hurt me a lot more than it's gonna hurt you. Quote the Raven, nevermore.
Lita, Batista with a devastating attack on Kane. You know, I can't get over the power of this man. And my question is this, is Batista actually with Ric Flair?
The following contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from Boston, Massachusetts, weighing 241 pounds, Aaron Stevens.
You know, Coach, I don't know if it was coincidence that Batista helped out Flair or if Triple H maybe had something to do because he have his back since Triple H was not able to be there.
You know, that's a good point. The game always seems to have his hand in something, whether or not he's in the arena
from
or not.
Lowry,
that didn't make any sense.
I gotcha. They gotcha.
Well, here comes Raven set to take on Aaron Stevens one-on-one. We heard from Raven a few moments ago on his masterpiece in the Seven Deadly Sins. And I guess Raven does have a point to a certain extent.
To an extent, but you know what? I'm going to have to actually go with the beginning and call myself. I'm just going to call myself simple-minded. Sorry.
Well, we are very simple-minded, which is why we're always happy, you know, because things are very simple to us. But Raven is going to prove to us over the next few weeks, apparently, that we're living behind a mask.
Of hypocrisy and depravity.
We understand. We understand. But Aaron Stevens apparently didn't appreciate what Raven had to say. He said, I'll see you in the ring, freak. You know, so we'll see what Aaron Stevens brings to the table. And right now, he's bringing a lot. Here's a cover, hook of the leg, one, two, and a kick out by Raven. You know, right after this match, folks, we're going to take you back to all the highlights from Tough Enough 3 this past Thursday night, which, of course, airs right here on MTV. And what another emotional episode. And Mr. Nick, you talk about not being tough enough. That's in a little bit. But right now, Raven is certainly tough enough, Lita.
He actually, you know, he is tough enough right now. And maybe he wouldn't be so sore at everybody if he just wanted tough enough instead of having to, you know, work elsewhere for years and years before making it to the WWE.
Are you still talking about Raven?
Yeah, absolutely. I am.
Oh, okay. I just want to make sure that you're not off the beaten path. Oh, and Raven right into a big boot from Aaron Stevens into the corner right now. Oh, but just like that, a nice drop down toe hold by Raven and raking the face of
Aaron
Stevens.
Wiping the mat, his face up with the mat.
You know,
literally.
I think what Raven is intending to do is humiliate these guys. I think that's what he wants to do, is humiliate these guys. That's always been a trait of Raven. And not only does he want you to understand, but he wants to humiliate you as well. Big clothesline by Raven.
Working for Raven right now. 100% control of Aaron Stevens.
And now Aaron Stevens, oh, a big knee lift right to the kisser as well. And now Raven spreads those arms in a flock-like manner. I hate to even say that.
What is that?
Oh, now Raven effect. A Raven effect, and this is probably going to be a very, very quick one. And it is. Raven making a point here on Heat.
Raven!
Wait a second, though.
Example out of Aaron Stevens.
What is Raven doing now? Raven is grabbing the hand of it. No, he's not. No, he's later. Oh, my God! Raven just broke the finger of Aaron Stevens.
Aaron Stevens writhing in pain.
Oh, my God. Raven just broke two fingers on the hand of Aaron Stevens. Is this the point he is trying to make?
Zhang is doing it for his own good.
That hurt me more than it hurt you.
How can that possibly hurt you more than it hurt Aaron Stevens? Raven, despicable and disgusting, but victorious. Well, folks, right now, let's go back to this past Thursday night. Tough Enough 3. Who would be the next victim? Here's all the highlights. Check it out. MTV.
Coach, coming up, we've got Jackie and Molly one-on-one. The Divas go with some... Shattered Soldier for PlayStation 2 and Game Boy Advance.
That's your favorite game. And by the new Castro GTX. High mileage. We go from up to, oh,
from Brooklyn,
Italian New
York. New
Yorker.
Weighing 248 pounds, Johnny Stambouli.
You know, I must have a lot of heat on Sunday Night Heat, because earlier Raven was upset with what we said a couple of weeks ago.
Right.
And Johnny the Bull is still a little bit upset over what we said about him being, well, I guess what
he's
I said
so
about
upset with me. He just doesn't even look at me, doesn't talk to me, he can't even...
Well, because he can't have you, see? That was my whole point a few weeks ago. You know, I threw...
Well, look, let's give him another opportunity. So if he can back it up,
okay.
If he can back it up, then, hey,
if he can
we'll
back it up tonight, we will give him credit. So here we go, Johnny the Bull, one-on-one with my man D'Lo. But getting back to Big Papa Pump, we had no idea that we'd see him at Survivor Series coming out and laying the wood to Christopher Nowinski and Matt Hardy.
Mattitude got shut down, man.
Yeah, Mattitude did get shut down last Sunday, and then come Monday night, Eric Bischoff, obviously awaiting the arrival of Big Papa Pump, told Scott Steiner, you can have whatever you want as long as you sign with Raw.
Right. But did we see anything on the dotted line?
No, all I saw was Scott Steiner coming out during the main event, which we're going to see in just a little bit, a huge triple threat match to determine the number one contender. Nice arm drag by D'Lo. And Big Papa Pump coming out to ruin it all and causing... And I'm not going to tell you who won the match. We're going to show you in a little bit. But Scott Steiner stuck around all night long to, I think, Lita, kind of get a feel for how Raw is, how Eric Bischoff runs things, because you remember, Eric Bischoff and Scott Steiner certainly have a history together.
Right, and I mean, Steiner told Jericho flat out, hey, little man, in my vein as big as your whole arm, I might stick around for the main event tonight.
And speaking of Eric Bischoff, not get off the beaten path, but we we saw a reemergence of Val Venus. Oh,
right. We haven't seen him in a long time.
Yeah, we haven't seen him. We don't know if Val is part of Eric Bischoff's administration. Oh, wait a second. Nice roll by D'Lo. 1-2-0 and nearly a three count on Johnny the Bull. Hopefully we'll find out more about the reemergence of
Val. Bischoff administration, as you said, business-like.
Yeah, well, folks, as I mentioned earlier, mark it down on your calendars. Coming in January, live from the world in Times Square, we're going to celebrate the most successful program in the history of cable television, Raw. And you, the fans, get this, Lita. This is the most exciting part. You can log on to WWE.com. Oh, and now, oh, wait, Johnny the Bull! A huge backbreaker
on that upper back.
But you, the fans, can go to WWE.com and vote for your favorite moments of all time on Raw, and we will announce the number one. Actually, you know, we're going to announce a lot of them in that special in January. A lot of the past stars, present stars, all will be in the house together in January. It's going to be great. I'll
Raw
be there.
Stars, SmackDown stars.
I'll be there in my tuxedo.
And Coach will be there. Everybody, well, you write that part down too.
Yeah, of course, that's a selling point, sure. Well, now Johnny the Bull taking it to D'Lo, rather. And Johnny the Bull must have heard us. Wants to prove a point here.
Okay, and then we'll quit.
And then we'll lay off him. But right now, D'Lo, you got to believe that he wants a huge win here on Heat to try to impress Eric Bischoff and the new Raw GM. Right now, it appears, oh my goodness, D'Lo in a very precarious position.
Putting more pressure on the back of D'Lo, which is already injured. Johnny working on it earlier.
You're exactly right. Taking it again. You got to give him credit, and again.
Focused individual tonight in Johnny Stamboli.
And rolls D'Lo over. 1-2. But not a very, very good cover. I'll be honest with you. 1-2, and again, very lackluster cover. And I don't know why Johnny the Bull thinks he's going to beat D'Lo like that.
Johnny Stamboli, look, taking it out on the referee when D'Lo clearly had his shoulder up.
Well, now D'Lo attempting to get back to his feet. What an hour we've had for you so far. Don't forget, tomorrow night we're going to be live from North Charleston, South Carolina. If you're in the area, come out and see.
It's a little confusing.
Michaels.
It's North Charleston, South Carolina.
Exactly.
You know,
confusing.
It's confusing to some, but
it's a beautiful part of the country.
It's my neck of the woods.
It certainly is. And folks, tomorrow night, for the first time in over 5 years, the Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels, will get back into the ring on Raw. And he must defend his newly won World Heavyweight title. Nobody thought he could do it last Sunday. The Heartbreak Kid did it, and tomorrow night will defend that World Heavyweight title.
We'll see if he can do it again.
It's going to be a stiff challenge with who he has to face. We're going to show a little bit later on. Now D'Lo back to his feet, and D'Lo attempting to make the classic comeback. We got it in twice in the show. That's fantastic. But now D'Lo with Johnny the Bull out the rope. And now D'Lo's got Johnny the Bull up, and oh no, somebody make me sick. Is able to kick out.
Coach, you need to have like a little sign at the end in loving memory of D'Lo after the end of every show.
What can I say? We're friends.
Okay.
I like him. Everybody knows we're friends. I like him. I love doing the show with you now, though. I mean, but
well,
me
thanks,
and D'Lo,
Coach. I love doing the show with you.
Well, thank you very much. Yeah. All right. Enough of the love fest.
Okay.
Johnny the Bull.
Hey, Johnny the Bull.
Check out the power. Catches D'Lo. Once again, a true player's player. Well, folks, coming up next, right here on Sunday Night Heat. Tomorrow night live from North Charleston, South Carolina. But coming up, Jacqueline Molly next. Well, Lita, say what you want about Victoria.
Okay.
And I know you have. No, that's rhetorical. But Victoria certainly got the job done last Sunday at Survivor Series, defeating Trish, new women's champion. And now taking out Stacey on Monday night as well. She never stopped.
Introducing first, from Dallas, Texas, Jack Pollock.
I don't know what this new relationship is between Victoria and Steven Richards, but I don't like it.
Seems fitting.
Yeah, I know it does. Most Lux presents WWE Armageddon. Armageddon will be live Sunday, December 15th, from the Office Depot Center in Fort Lauderdale, Florida. Beautiful place. Hit the streets Lux style. Get the shoes with an attitude at Lux.com. And you know, Lita, tickets went on sale for Armageddon yesterday.
Yeah, but we will be there live. So.
We will be there live,
Molly Holly!
You know, we knew that Steven Richards is wacko, as you love to call him. But now that Steven apparently has a new relationship with Victoria, that's kind of dangerous mentally, in my opinion.
All the way around, I think it could be dangerous. For each other, maybe.
Well, I know.
Yeah, I don't know.
I know. Who would be the dominant one in that relationship? Holy cow. Well, here we go. Molly and Jacqueline, two women that, quite frankly, don't like each other. Two former women's champions. And these two, whenever they battle, it is brutal, it is physical, and here we go.
Victoria, you know, has got to have her eye out watching these two girls right now. Now, her being the hunted one, her with the bullet on her head, bullet, the what?
Yeah,
the what?
Yeah,
the bullseye.
The bullseye on her head is what you're trying to say.
Yeah.
Exactly. But I think what you're pointing out is that Victoria liked being the hunter. I don't know if Victoria's not going to be in
the hunter.
Exactly. I'm not sure. Oh, wait a second. Nice roll by Jacqueline. 1-2. And easily
nice
kick up on Molly. Was that?
So that was a nice roll up. But no.
Not enough. There's a cover. 1-2. And again, a kick out by Molly. But, you know, getting back tomorrow night, what a huge night it's going to be from the North Charleston Coliseum in North Charleston, South Carolina.
Coach.
What?
HBK. RVD. One-on-one.
I think you finally got it. And everybody at home now has it too. And folks, if you're in the South Carolina area tomorrow, get out and see Raw live. And of course, you don't want to miss it tomorrow night. 9 o'clock, 8
wow,
Central,
Molly's
live on the new TNN.
Taking out Jackie's knee.
Well, Molly is a very good tactician in the ring.
Tacticianist, maybe? Well, is there like a female tacticianist?
I don't know what you'd call a female tacticianist, but if there is one, she would be one.
Tacticianista.
And now going after that left knee of Jacqueline, and again, you know, I think that is French. Is that French?
I don't know.
It might be French. But right
now,
Molly is certainly not flashy by any stretch of the imagination.
But this is working.
Yeah.
But pressure on me is pressure on you.
Effectiveness sometimes is better than flash. And now, Molly, wait a second. Am I seeing? Well, you know, I'm kind of looking
well,
at it. I didn't want to even point it out.
Okay.
Well,
let's
I won't
go
point
to
it out.
Molly still on Jackie's left leg.
Snapping Jacqueline over, and that left knee is taking a beating, and Molly is relentless. But folks, as Lita so poignantly pointed out a few moments ago, tomorrow night, the Heartbreak Kid Shawn Michaels one-on-one with Rob Van Dam live on Raw for the first time in over 5 years. Shawn Michaels gets back into the ring on Raw. And what a special night. These are the type of moments and nights that we're going to recap at the Raw Anniversary Special.
Coach, you know what I was actually thinking, not to cut you off, but Rob, you know, everything's always so cool with him. He's always chilled out.
Oh.
Is he going to be thrown off by being in there with one of his idols that he pointed out?
Well, Rob Van Dam makes no bones about it. He's always loved Shawn Michaels, has emulated Shawn Michaels, has always wanted to be like the Heartbreak Kid. And I think tomorrow night, what a special night it would be if indeed RVD can become the World Heavyweight Champion tomorrow night. What a special night it would be not only become champion, but to defeat his idol.
Absolutely.
You bring up a very, very good point, which is why it's going to be a special night tomorrow night from South Carolina. But right now, Molly is still in complete control. I cannot remember the last time. Oh, wait a second. Reversal and sunset flip. 1-2. And nearly getting the 3 count on Molly was Jacqueline. And here's a back bridge. Again, 2. And Molly again is able to kick out.
Jackie trying to stay quick with a lot of damage done to that left leg.
You gotta wonder how much damage has been done to that left leg at this point.
You gotta wonder, but devastating elbow, no teeth on the mat though this time, no blood.
Thank goodness. I don't like to see hot chicks missing teeth.
Me neither.
You know, oh my goodness! A modified bulldog and Jacqueline pulling Molly into position for a quick cover.
Oh, I thought that was gonna be it.
May have waited a tad too long for that cover. Oh, wait a second. Oh, and a quick roll by Molly. 1-2. Oh, she gets it.
Seizing the moment.